ओके, व्हाई आर नॉट लुकिंग सो स्मार्ट टुडे? आर यू ओके?
यस वी आर ओके.
देन गिव मी योर क्यूट स्माइल, देन आफ्टर दैट वी कैन बिगिन द सेशन. Come on, give a cute smile. Okay, okay.
Good morning, ma'am.
Okay, good morning. I love you all. I like you all. Are you ready for your science social class?
Yes.
PBS 2
yes.
class?
Yes.
Yes.
Now, today we are going to discuss the workbook exercises.
Okay, ma'am.
Okay. I want everybody, please take out your workbook. Part 1, take out your workbook.
Mama, I have a workbook. Mama, part 1, I have a workbook.
Please, everybody, take out your part 1 workbook.
Yes, ma'am. Yes, ma'am. Yes, ma'am.
Show me your book in front of the camera.
Yes.
Show me your book in front of the camera. Take page number. We have completed the first page, right?
Page number.
Who's talking in Malayalam? Show me your book in front of the camera. Brinda, show me your book. Archa, Nakshatra. Diya, unmute. Okay, let's begin. So the first question here, ma'am, is going to ask some questions to you. What is drawn to mark events in the order in which they took place? Lifeline, timeline, number line, future. What is answer?
Timeline.
Timeline. Which of the following is a noted source of history? Oral source, written source, archaeological source, water source?
Water source.
Water source.
Water source. Then fill in the blanks. The past comes before?
Now.
On a timeline, the dash event is on the left-hand side.
First
event. Okay. Which language does the word history come from?
Greek.
Give one example of oral history.
Story.
You can write story. You can write song. Okay. Poems also you can write. Now, short answer question. Give two examples of archaeological sources of history.
Buildings
you can write. Tools you can write. Then clothes, jewelry. I think we have completed all these answers, right?
Yes.
Tell me, Mutu, true or false?
Yes.
That we have completed in the last class. Do you remember?
Yes.
Okay, here I'll ask the questions one more time. Everyone studies history for the same reason.
False.
Oral sources of history are used to learn languages. We need to study history to know why events happened in the past.
True.
History cannot help us learn about the changes in the world.
False.
History can help us. History can help us to know, to learn about the changes in the world. So So the sentence is false. Shall we move to next question?
Yes.
Okay. After the discussion and after writing, I'll be sending the notes to the WhatsApp by evening. So shall I share the screen?
Yes.
Okay. Are you ready with your pencil?
Yes.
Yes.
Yes, I know. My children are ready. Somebody's device, I can hear much disturbance. I don't know. Shivada's device, I think. Shivada muted. Nakshatra muted. Yeah, somebody started writing. Danish. Anushka, stop playing with your devices. Number 12. Why are written sources of history important? Why? They teach us about.
Teach us about.
Famous people and places. They.
teach us about famous people and places.
Okay, first up.
And people and places.
They teach us about. Why are, okay, the question is, why are written sources of history important? They teach us about famous people and places. Different people and places. Number 13. What is the 13th question, you know? You want to learn more about your grandmother. What are the two ways to doing so, of doing so? If you want to learn more about your grandmother.
Yes.
Okay, just imagine you would like to learn more, to know more about your grandmother. What are the two ways doing so? Oh, I can learn about my grandmother from her. Old photographs. If we want to learn about our grandmother, what is the first material? What are the old things we can photos. Do? Yeah, we can search for her old photographs and different stories that people remember about her. That means we can ask about others. Oh, do you know, can you tell us about my grandma, whether she is beautiful, whether she was a kind of lady? Huh? Okay, 1 minute. Now look at the board. Everybody write. I can learn about my grandmother. Don't make spelling mistakes. G-R-A-N-D, grandmother. Mother spelling M-O-T-H-E-R, mother. I can learn. Somebody has started drawing. How many times ma'am is repeating? Don't do it. I can learn about. Akshay, rub the board. Akshay. Please stop doing playing with your device. Akshay. So here is the answer. How can I know about my grandmother? I can learn about my grandmother. From old photographs.
From old photographs.
P-H-O-T-O-G-R-A-P-H. Yes. Photographs. Old. Her old photographs. I can learn about my grandmother from old photographs. And the different stories and the different different and the different and the different stories
different stories
that people remember, that people remember. Okay, Akshay, still you are doing? Where is Akshay? He's playing. He's not writing the notes. Akshay, don't play with your device. Write the notes.
Remember.
I can see him. All my children are writing.
A, B, O, U, T, about her.
Okay. So here is the answer. I'll repeat once again. How can I learn about my grandmother? I can learn about my grandmother from old photographs and the different stories that people remember about her. Is that clear to you?
Yes.
Shall we move to next question?
Yes.
Shall we move to next question?
Yes. Yes.
What are these people doing? That's a long answer question number 14. Everybody look at your textbook. Your workbook. Okay, look at the picture, the first picture. What are these two people doing? Right, how history can help these people, these two people with what they do. What is the first person doing? He is making pots. Okay, those who make pots, we can call them Potter. Say all of you, he is a potter.
He is a potter.
Okay, those who treat a patient, look after the patients.
Doctor.
Give medicine.
Doctor.
Now look at the picture, who is that? A doctor. Can you see a doctor there?
Yes.
Okay. Then the first picture, everybody look at the picture A. You can see one potter. He is making pots. Can you please touch and show me the potter? Show me the potter in front of the camera, everybody. Oh, very good, very good, very good. Oh, a person who make pots. Who is that? Potter. Say all of you. Potter. Stefania, a person who makes pots. We can call him
Potter.
Potter. Then a person who treat, give medicines.
Doctor.
Doctor. So we can write down the answer. And how history help these people? Because a potter can learn about the materials that were used to make pots earlier. A potter has to study about history. So the different materials that he used earlier. Okay.
Okay, ma'am.
Then doctor, why do a doctor need to study about history? A doctor needs to study in history.
When?
He has to know about different diseases and the treatments of the past. Why do a doctor need to study history? He has to know about different diseases and the treatments of the past.
Of the past.
So we can write down the answer. Yes. What happened? Look at the board and write.
Mom, I write on my rough book these words when you write on the board.
That's okay. You can copy down later to the workbook.
Okay, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am.
Ma'am?
Who is talking? Somebody's device, too much voice disturbance. So we are going to write that long answer question. What are these two people doing? Look at the picture and say, who is that in the first picture? Tell me, children. Potter. Who is that in the first picture?
Potter.
Potter. And why do a potter need to study history? He has to know about the materials that were used to make pots earlier.
Earlier.
Earlier. Has to know about the materials that used in the past. Okay, right. Picture A. Underline. Then write the answer. The potter.
The potter. P-O-T-T-E-R.
Is making pots. Everybody write with ma'am. The potter is making pots. Put a full stop.
Then. Yes.
How history can help these two people with what they do? He can learn about the materials.
He can learn about
the materials. materials. See the spelling carefully. MATERIALS. Materials that were were used to make pots earlier. That were used in the past. Used in the past. Put a full stop. Why do a potter needs to study history? He can learn about the materials that were used in the past. Any difficulty?
No.
Then picture B. A doctor. A doctor. Picture
that.
B. A doctor. A doctor treating a doctor is treating 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 a patient. A patient. A doctor is treating a patient. Put a full stop. Why do you think children a doctor need to study about history? To know the different diseases and the treatments of the past. To know why do a doctor need to study about history? To know. Next point. To know. To know about different diseases. About different diseases. Don't make spelling mistakes. Write carefully. Different. D-I-F-F-E-R-E-N-T. Different diseases. D-I-S-E-A-S-E-S. Different diseases. And treatments of the past. And treatments, T-R-E-A-T, and treatments of the past.
T-R-E-A-T-I-N-G, treatment
of the past.
Treatment
of the past. A doctor is treating a patient to know about different diseases and the treatments of the past. Finish all of you?
No. Not finished.
Have you completed, children?
Yes.
So now tell me the answer. What are these two people doing? Picture A. The potter making pots.
Making pots.
Okay. Why do a potter needs to learn about the history? To learn about the materials.
To learn about
materials that were used in the
past.
Used in the past. Very good. Now, what is picture B? Who is that in the picture B?
Doctor.
Very good. A doctor. What is he doing? Ellen, what is he doing, Ellen? A doctor. What is he doing in this picture?
Treating a patient.
Okay. Why do a doctor need to study about history? To know about different diseases and treatments of the past. Is that clear to you?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. Now, we are moving to multiple choice question. Can you show me that multiple choice question? You can see some pictures there. All of you touch and show me. Oh, question number 15. If you make a timeline of your life, which event will come first? Which event will come first? Your birth, your first day at school. Which one? Which event will come first?
Birth.
Okay, exactly. So option A. Option
A.
Everybody, right? Option A. Everybody, right? Option A. Shall we move to next question?
Yes.
Okay. That is another multiple choice question. Who among these cannot help you to find about your family history? Your father, your aunt cannot help you. Okay. Your grandmother, your baby sister.
Your baby sister.
Baby sister cannot help us to learn about our family history. But our father can tell us, am I right?
Yes.
Our mother can tell.
Yes.
Our aunt can tell.
Yes.
Our grandmother can tell.
Yeah.
But our baby sister cannot tell about our family history. Okay, because she is a little girl. So which option?
Option D.
Is it clear, children?
Yes.
Okay. Not much time. I think the next answers we can discuss in the next class. Is that fine?
Yes, ma'am.
Or I'll see. Then after that, I'll send the notes to the WhatsApp. Okay. Here, everybody look at the 17th picture. You can see a temple. What beautiful temple in that picture. Can you touch and show me? That beautiful temple, show me. Come close to the camera and show me. Oh, okay. Here, ma'am is going to tell one story. Sakshi, one of our friend named Sakshi. What is our friend's name? Sakshi.
Sakshi.
Okay. Sakshi has got a chance to visit an old temple. Temple, we all know that we used to take prayers to God. Okay, how many of you are going to temple to take prayers, to pray to God? We used to go to temple. Okay. We used to go to mosque, we used to go to church and temple to take prayers. Now, our Sakshi got a chance to visit one old temple in Konark. It's a place name, Odisha. Okay, where did she go? She got a chance to go to a temple. She got a chance to go to a
temple.
Okay, where is that temple? Odisha.
Odisha.
Where is that temple?
Odisha. Say all of you.
Odisha. Temple. Which type of his source of history does the temple belong to? That is an old temple. It's a building. Is that an oral source of history?
No.
Is that a written source of history?
No.
Is that an archaeological source of history?
Yes.
Yes, exactly. temple is an archaeological sources of history. Now, what Sakshi can know about the history of Odisha from that temple? One day, our friend Sakshi, she got a chance to go and visit one old temple. In, where is that old temple? Odisha.
Odisha.
Okay. And she visited, I don't know, maybe she has visited with her parents, her grandparents. But
yeah.
Tell me, which type of sources of history is that temple?
Archaeological
source of history. Okay. Now let me tell you, let me ask one more thing. One day I got a chance to visit one old palace in Tripunithara, Kochi. What a type of, which a source of history that? I got a chance to go to a palace.
Archaeology source
of history. Okay. Okay, we will discuss this answer in our next class. Is that fine?
Yes.
Okay. Let us wind up the session. Bye-bye. Love you all.
Thank you, ma'am.
Bye-bye. Come, close your books. Close your books and come close to the camera. Will you read the answers?
Yes.
Will you write and study the answers?
Yes.
Because there are some difficult spellings. Will you write and study all those spellings? The words.
Ma'am, how much time?
5 times. That is enough. Only 5 times. Is that
okay,
fine?
Okay, ma'am. Yes.
Okay. So, before going, 1 minute. Okay, who has joined the class named Vava? Who's that? Okay. I didn't get her name. Children, when you join the class, please rename your device with your name. Otherwise, here teachers are putting attendance. Here, ma'am is taking attendance. I just took a pic of your class. So I have to put the attendance. No. So make sure that when you join the class, please name. Your name. Please put your name. Okay, children?
Yes,
so that's
ma'am.
All for today. Bye-bye. Love you all.
Bye, ma'am. Love you, ma'am.
Take care. Bye-bye.
Bye, ma'am.
Okay, do one thing. You have to write and study these answers 5 times.
Okay,
bye-bye. That's all for today. Let's find a position. Come close to the camera and give me a cute smile. Bye-bye.
Love you, ma'am.
Go and have your lunch. Okay.
Love you, ma'am.
Love you too, my little ones. Love you.